y'all, what's up? Welcome back, Manny with My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today we're talking about water parameters and why they are so important in preventing your fish from getting sick. So I made a video a while back about the common fish diseases and some of the stuff that you can do to prevent it or to treat it. So I have been getting so many questions about why people are having problems with their fish and what kind of problems they're having. I've been noticing a couple of common things that are going on with a lot of these people. So a huge reason that a lot of fish will get sick is water quality. Water quality is so important. Making sure that you cycle your tank before adding your fish in, especially if you have fish that are extremely sensitive to any kind of parameter fluctuation. It's very important to make sure that you have enough good bacteria built up in the tank to take care of any ammonia and nitrites that build up in the tank. I do have a video that goes a little bit more in detail about the nitrogen cycle, and I will put a link to it in the description below. So ammonia and nitrites are extremely, extremely toxic to fish, especially ammonia. Ammonia is a fish killer. It can cause a wide variety of problems. The biggest one that I see quite frequently is ammonia burn. And then of course, ammonia in your tank can wipe out your entire fish tank. It can kill all of your fish within a matter of hours, sometimes even less. So you really, really want to make sure that you are monitoring your tank for any ammonia or nitrites, because fish cannot handle these two things. Because ammonia and nitrites, again, are very, very, very toxic to fish. Now, fish can handle up to a certain amount of nitrates, but once they're over a certain limit, once they reach that threshold, it is going to cause a lot of stress to your fish, and it can still also get them sick and cause them to be more susceptible to diseases. So keeping your fish in low quality water is not going to be good for them. So making sure that you do your routine maintenance and making sure that you are doing water testing can really help take care of this problem. So another problem that I'm seeing a lot of is incorrect tank temperatures. So some fish need to be kept at specific temperatures, and they can maybe fluctuate between 1 or 2 degrees throughout the day, but their temperature really needs to stay pretty consistent at whatever temperature that fish requires. There are a lot of fish out there that need to be kept between like 78, 82 degree type ranges, and they can only tolerate a fluctuation throughout the day of 1 or 2 degrees. If you are keeping fish like this, then you need to make sure that you are keeping a quality heater, one that is preferably an adjustable heater, so that you know that your fish is gonna be kept at the correct temperature at all times. And of course, you still wanna keep a thermometer in your tank to make sure that your heater is functioning properly, because let's face it, sometimes heaters just don't work right. And sometimes you have a heater for several years, you never have a problem, and then all of a sudden one day, it's a problem. Also, I would say always check reviews on heaters, because some of them have been known to cause a lot of issues in tanks where they malfunction, they overheat, and it's, of course, never a good thing. There was one, I don't remember what brand it was, but there was one type of heater that I know there was a recall on it because it was actually electrocuting fish. So you definitely want to check reviews before buying a heater and make sure that you keep a thermometer in the tank so that you can make sure that it is functioning properly. Another issue is water parameters. So some fish need harder water, some fish need softer water, some fish need more acidic conditions, some fish may be actually a brackish fish. I've seen so many fish out there that are labeled freshwater fish, and yes, they can handle freshwater maybe when they're younger, but they actually really need to be kept in brackish water. So always do your research on the type of fish that you are keeping and the type of conditions that those fish really need to be in. Because if you have a fish that needs to, say, be at a pH of 6 to 7, and that fish is being kept in a tank that is at a pH of 8, then that fish is gonna probably end up experiencing a lot of physical stress because they're not in the environment that they should be in. and that can end up leaving them again more susceptible to diseases. A lot of this is all about prevention and water quality and making sure that fish are kept in the right environment, because if they're not in the right environment, it stresses them out, it stresses out their bodies, because their body is trying to keep up with things and trying to deal with being in an incorrect environment that they're just not built for. And that is gonna leave them more open to getting a lot of health problems. And of course, we want our fish that we purchase to be happy and healthy and have a long lifespan. And unfortunately, if you're keeping a fish in incorrect conditions, then they probably are not gonna be around very long. So let's talk about water testing. I know there are a lot of beginners out there, and water testing can maybe seem overwhelming. All the information about keeping water at certain levels and everything can seem maybe overwhelming, but testing your water on a regular basis to make sure that all your water parameters are where they should be is so crucial to make sure that you are providing the best conditions for your fish to live in. Now, I know that a lot of the fish stores around me do actually offer free water testing. They can test your water, and not only will they test your water, they will go over all of where your water parameters are at. And some of them even have enough knowledge that they can help you to know where the water parameters should be for the type of fish that you are keeping. So if you do have a fish store nearby you that does offer free water testing and that does have a lot of knowledge about fish, then definitely, if you are a beginner, definitely use that service, have them help you, have them teach you kind of what all those parameters mean. And they can also show you different things that you can do as far as making sure to get the water where it needs to be for the particular fish that you are keeping. Now, there are also test strips that you can purchase at most fish stores. I've seen these pretty commonly. They're really easy. You pretty much just stick the test strip into the water, and you usually line it up with the little paper to see, you know, what color the strip comes up to see where your water parameters are at. That way, it's really simple and it's easy to do. These test strips are a little bit expensive, but they're really simple. They're easy to read, easy to use. The only issue with these is that if they encounter any humidity, it can mess up the test strips and render them kind of useless. There are also master test kits that are really awesome. They're very elaborate. They can tell you pretty much all your levels and everything, and they can give you a lot of information, a lot of feedback about where all your levels are at. And that'll give you more information to know what needs to be adjusted and what maybe changes that you need to make. And it'll give you a more accurate reading than, say, the test strips. So the master kits are fantastic as far as really, really getting an in-depth idea as to where all your water parameters are at. And it gives you a better picture as to what kind of adjustments maybe you need to make. Maybe it's just as simple as you need to do water changes every 4 days instead of every 6 days. And that will give you a better picture to know exactly when you need to change your water and how much. So that leads me into tank maintenance. Tank maintenance is so, so important. Making sure that you are doing your water changes on a regular basis can be extremely important, and that's where water testing comes in. It'll tell you exactly how frequently you really need to be doing your water changes. I know a lot of us, after a while, we kind of just know how often we usually need to change our water. But if you're a beginner, testing your water so that you can really have a good idea as to how often you need to be changing your water can really help you out. Making sure that you're doing your routine maintenance, making sure that you're changing out any filter media or anything that you need to as needed. Also checking to make sure that your filter and your heater and everything is functioning properly so that you're getting that ideal water flow. Sometimes some of these filters can get clogged up, and they might not be filtering your water properly. You might not be getting as much water circulation as you really need to in that aquarium. And so this is why we want to do routine maintenance. We want to check everything is functioning properly, and we want to make sure that the water circulation in the tank is proper for the fish that we are trying to keep, and that the water quality is right where it needs to be. So pretty much the biggest factor in making sure that your fish are happy and healthy is going to be making sure that you're doing proper maintenance, keeping your fish in the proper environment and the proper water conditions for that particular type of fish. making sure that if you need a heater, that you get a heater and that it is maintaining the proper temperature in the tank. So all these things can really, really prevent a lot of illnesses just by keeping the fish in the proper environment, in the water parameters that it needs, so that that way the fish doesn't get stressed out physically and can live its full potential. And you can keep your fish nice and healthy, and they will be less likely to get any diseases. And of course, there's other good preventative measures that you can take, such as keeping a quarantine tank, so that way if you are wanting to add additional fish to your tank, that you have somewhere to put them to quarantine them to make sure that they are healthy before you add them to your current tank. So anyway, guys, I really hope that this information really helps a lot of you guys out there. I know that I've been getting so many questions, and these are some of the main things that I've been noticing, so I thought I would come on here and talk about it a little bit. And I really hope that it helps you guys out. Okay, so that's all for today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye!